At the end of the last video, we arrived at the slope value for our sample data. We will start this video by looking at the different ways through which we can make sense of this slope value.
If we want to analyze the slope formula using the initial values, we can say that for every 252.5 units increase in the predictor variable, the response variable would go down by -75.5 units. On the other hand, if we are saying that the slope is -0.3, it means that for every 1 unit increase in the predictor variable, the response variable would go down by -0.3 units. Also note that if we rewrite the slope value -0.3 as -3/10, it would mean that for every 10 point increase in the predictor variable, the response variable would go down by -3 points. I want to clarify one thing. The regression line we make using the least square method is known as the best fitting line. We call it the best fitting line because based on the data we have, this is the best line we can make to predict our response variable. So I would use the word regression line and the best fitting line interchangeably. We can now get back to our example data. Now that we have the slope value, we can calculate our intercept value using the line equation y equal to mx plus b. As already explained in the previous video, this formula of intercept requires a corresponding value of x and y that is on the regression line. But since we don't know any of the points that are on the regression line, we can use the mean of the predictor variable x and the mean of the response variable y in place of x and y in this equation. This is because the mean of the predictor and the response variable is present on the best fitting line. If we place the mean of the x variable, mean of the y variable, and the slope we calculated above in this equation, we would get the intercept as 17.94059, which again for the sake of simplicity can be rewritten as 18. Now that we have the slope and intercept value, we can place these values in the line equation and get the value of response variable for any given value of the predictor variable. Lastly, we are going to see how to make the regression line or the best fitting line using the slope and intercept value we just calculated. This is the scatter plot for our data that has one predictor and one response variable. Our intercept we just calculated is 18. In other words, when the predictor variable is 0, the response variable is still 18. On our vertical axis at 18, we would make our first mark, which would be the starting point of our regression line, also known as the best fitting line. The slope we calculated is -3/10, which means that for every 10 point increase in the predictor variable, the response variable would go down by -3 points. From our initial point 18 on the vertical axis, we will move right by 10 because our horizontal axis represents our predictor variable. And then we will move down by -3 because our vertical axis represents our response variable. We would make our second mark on this location. We will repeat the process one more time. From this second mark, we will move right by 10 and then again move down by -3 to make our third mark. Now we can connect the three orange marks we made using the intercept and slope values to make the best fitting line or regression line for our example data. The vertical dotted line that I have drawn between each individual xy point and the regression line represents the distance between them.
In this video, we looked at the different ways through which we can analyze the slope value. Using the slope value, we then calculated the intercept value for the sample data. Finally, we looked at the process of making the regression line in a scatter plot using the slope and intercept value.
In the next video, we will look at different ways we can find out whether the line of best fit is a good predictor of the response variable or not.